Welcome to all to the second session of the module 4. In the previous session, we discussed about the excitation table. Okay, so how to get the excitation table from the characteristic table or the truth table. And we get the excitation table for all the four flip-flops, that is SR flip-flop, the JK flip-flop, the T flip-flop, and the D flip-flop. So, and I said in the previous session that excitation table is very useful when we are designing a synchronous counter. Okay. So today we will discuss about the one of the synchronous counter design. Okay. So as an example, first we'll take up the mod 6 synchronous counter. Again, when I say a synchronous counter, there may be a up counting or down counting. Up counting in terms of increment, down counting is in terms of decrement. Okay. So here we try to design a mod 6 synchronous up counter. Okay, so this is the first thing that we'll do, up counting. When I say a mod 6, it will have the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, and here we can have our sequence in any fashion that we want. But in this example, I have considered the sequence to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then back to 0. It is something like this, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and again the sequence continues. Okay, so 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is a continuous sequence that we have. Okay, you can design a mod 6 synchronous counter in any fashion. Okay, in any sequence, need not be in a particular sequence. You can rearrange this. It can be 0, 2, 1, 5, 4, 3, again 0 to 1, 5, 4, 3. Okay, so that we call it as an arbitrary. But for starting or to start with, we'll have this mod 6 synchronous up counter, which usually counts the sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in an increment fashion. Okay, so in order to design a synchronous counter, okay, I can design synchronous counter using JK flip-flop, using SR flip-flop, using D or using T flip-flop. I can use any flip-flop in designing this counter. But in this example, we'll see the mod 6 synchronous up counter using JK flip-flop. So we try to use JK flip-flop in designing the mod 6 synchronous up counter with the sequence 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then back to 0. So whenever we try to design the synchronous counter, we need two things. One is the present state, as you can see in this transition table, and then the next state. And before going to the present state and the next state, we have to identify how many flip-flops we require or this particular problem requires in designing the mod 6. And as I said, mod 6 means it has a count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the biggest or the largest count being the 5. Okay, so minimum bits to represent 5 is 3. So we require 3 flip-flops. Okay, and just going into this transition table, as I said, we require the present state and the next state. Present state, we have 3 present state because of 3 flip-flop that is required in order to design this mod 6. Okay, so there are 3 flip-flops, as I said, A, B, and C. Okay, so QA is nothing but what the output of A flip-flop, QB is the output of B, and QC is the output of C. This will be the present state. The next state of A flip-flop is QA plus. In some textbook, they might have given A of T plus 1. Okay, so in this, I have taken it is QA plus. For next state of QB is QB plus. Next state of QC is QC plus. This is what I have done. Okay, so first we'll try to concentrate on the present state and the next state. And this transition table differs from different counter design. Okay, so this is an exclusive or unique for the mod 6 synchronous sub counter for this particular count sequence. Okay, don't think that the present state and the next state will be the same for every flip flop. No. So coming back to this present state, since we require 3 flip flop, I have specified the outputs of 3, that is QA, QB, and QC, where QA is the least significant bit and QC is the most significant bit. Okay. And what I mean by the synchronous counter means, compared to the asynchronous counter that we discussed in the module 3, In synchronous counter, all the flip-flops that we use in designing this synchronous counter uses a common clock. Clock is same. That's why we say all the flip-flops are in synchronous with a common clock. That's why it is called mod 6 or the synchronous counter. Sorry. Again, coming back to this present state, since I have five different states, six different states, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I will take one of the valid present state is 0. Okay. If the counter is in the present state 0, that means 0, 0, 0, binary equivalent of 0, the next state in defining my up counter is 1. So present state, if it is 0, 0, 0, means the next state will be 0, 0, 1, which is nothing but what? 1 in decimal. Okay. If the present state is 1, means the next state will be 2. If the present state is 2, next state will be 3. If the present state is 3, next state will be 4. You can see here, present state is 1. The next state will be present state 0, next state 1. If this becomes the present state, the next state will be 2. Similarly, it goes on. So that's why in the present state, if I'm in state 4 or count 4, the next state will be 5. And if I have the present state is 5, means obviously my next count will be 0 because I have defined this. Okay. And again, if the present state is 0, means again it will go to 1. Okay, this sequence keeps on going. And now, once we have the present state and the next state of the flip-flop, then we should find out the flip-flop inputs. And that is what we get from the excitation table. If we know the present state and the next state of any flip-flop, we can find out its corresponding inputs. And here, we are designing this synchronous up-counter using JK flip-flop. We are interested in the excitation table of JK flip-flop. Okay, this is what the JK inputs for the corresponding present state and next state. What this means is, if I'm having a transition from present state 0 to next state 0, my J remains 0 and K will be don't care. If the present state is 0 and the next state is 1, means J remains 1, K will be don't care. Similar fashion, if I'm having a present state to next state transition as 1, 0, it will be don't care 1. And if it is 1, 1, don't care 0. And we, in the previous session, we came to know how to get this inputs J and K when I have a transition of present state to the next state. Coming back to this design now, since we have three flip-flops, I require three sets of inputs for each. One set of input for JK is JAKA, another flip-flop inputs will be JBKB, and the third flip-flop input will be JCKC. Okay. So in order to get the values for JA and KA, I'm interested in the present state of QA and the next state of QA plus 1. Okay, this is what important for me. So depending upon the QA and QA plus 1 transition, then I'll find out what is my JA and KA. Now, if I take the first row in this present state and the next state, we can see that the present state is 0 here and the next state is 1. So I have a present state 0 to next state 1. Present state to next state, it is 1 don't care. That's why I have 1 don't care. In the second, present state is 1, next state is 0, I have don't care 1. You can see that. Present state 1, next state 0, it is don't care 1. I'm just entering the value of JK corresponding to present state and the next state. Next, 0 to 1 transition, it is 1 don't care. 1 to 0, it is don't care 1. 0 to 1, it is 1 don't care. 1 to 0, it is don't care 1. Okay. Similarly, we will find out the values of JB, KB and JC, KC from QB, QB plus for JBKB, QC, QC plus columns for JCKC. Okay. So coming to the JBKB, JB 0, JB plus, that is present state 0 to next state 0, it is 0, don't care. This is the reference. 0 to 1, it is 1, don't care. 1 to 1, it is don't care 0. 1 to 0, it is don't care 1. That's why it is don't care 1. 0 to 0, the first one, it is 0, don't care. So, sorry, 0 to 0, it is, yeah, 0, don't care. 0 to 0, again, it is 0, don't care. Okay, so I got JBKB along with JAK. Now, to get the JC and KC, I'm interested in the QC and QC plus 1. Okay, so again, present state 0 to next state 0, it is 0, don't care. Present state 0, next state 0, again it is 0, don't care. Present state to next state 0, 0, it is 0, don't care. Present state 0, next state 1, it is 1, don't care. Present state is 1, next state is 1, don't care 0. Present state is 1, next state is 1, don't care 1. Okay, so in this fashion, we'll construct the transition table, which is having the present state, the next state, and the flip-flop inputs. The moment we have the present state, next state, and the flip-flop inputs, now I can find out the expression for JC, KC, JB, KB, and finally JA and KA. This is what I want to find out now. Okay, so these are the things to find out now. Okay, now how to get the expression now? So in order to get the expression for JC, KC, JB, KB, JA, KA, I need to get the K-map. And all of you have studied in module 1 and 2. In module 1, basically, the K-map, Carnot map, how to enter the values and how to simplify any expression, or given the table, how to enter and get the simplified or the minimal sum of products or something. Okay, so now, so in order to find the JCK and all, in order to find out the expression for JAK, as I said, we need K-map. And how many variable K-map is very important here. Okay, I can't define one, two variable or three variable, four variable as of my wish. I can't do that. Okay, so the number of variable K-map that we use depends upon the present state. Okay, how many present states are there? Three. So I require three variable K-map. In some cases, the number of variable K-map depends upon the present state as well as any other inputs are there. Okay, in this particular example, there are no additional inputs, only present states are there. So we define, or we want, how many present states are there, that number of variable K-map. So now I require three variable K-map. Okay, so QA being the least significant and QC being the most significant. Okay, so now we'll try to enter JC value. So that means, for example, as an example, I'll just take up this. Okay, to get the expression for JC. So for JC, I need to know what is my QC? QC plus one. Okay, so QC being the most significant, that I will take it in terms of rows. And here I'll be going with QB, QA bar. And this will be my QB bar QA. And this will be QB QA. And finally, I have QB QA bar. Okay. So you can see that all these define. This is my cell 0. This is my cell 1. This is my cell 2. This is my cell 3. This is my 4, 5, 6, and 7. Okay. So now 0, 0, 0 means I'm in this cell. So what is the value of JC? That is 0. That you have to enter. Similarly, 0, 0, 1, correspondingly, this is 0. So for 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, that is 2, my JC is 0. That's why it is 0. Next, for 0, 0, 1, 3, my JC is 1. For 1, 0, 0, it is don't care. Put. For 1, 0, 1, it is don't care. Okay. So first 3 0, next 3 1 don't care. And whatever the remaining is there, you just simply put the don't care, because I don't know what exactly the thing is. And this is a simple one. And now, in order to get the minimal group, I have this. So one minimum group I get. So JC is simply QB into QA. That is the expression. So for the C JK flip-flop, JC, I'll be giving simply the AND operation of the output of B flip-flop and the output of A flip-flop. That's it. And in some of the textbook, instead of using QC, QB, QA, they will be using CBA as a present state, C plus B plus A plus as the next state. All are one and the same. Okay, so, and that's what we'll try to see in the next thing. Okay, we'll go to the next slide now in order to get the expression for all these inputs of flip-flops. Now you can see here, as I said, This is similar to QA bar. This is QA. This is QB bar, QC bar, QB bar, QC, QB, QC. This is QB, QC bar. Okay. So just now I gave an example of to find JC. There I got QA, QB. Here it will be in terms of AB. That's it. So what they have done is basically, okay, so they have done this one. This A, it is nothing but what QA for me. This B is nothing but what QB. That's what I had taken in the previous class. This is nothing but what QC. Okay. So AB is nothing but what QA, QB. Just we define. Okay. In the similar fashion, we'll try to enter the KC again using three variable KMAP and get the expression. This is A or it will be QA. For JA, it is 1. 1 means it is VCC. For KA, it is 1. That means 1 means all these pin group 1. This is all grouped as 1. Okay. Here it is simply this. Here it is simply this. Okay. So this is what I'm trying to have. Okay. So this is what, or sorry, this is group of 4, not group of 2. This is group of 4. That's why it is A. This is group of 2. That's why you'll be getting A and B something. Okay, this is what you'll have. And for JB, you have something called QA, QC bar. Here it will be simply QA. Yes. These are all the different expression. This is with respect to this group. And this is with respect to this group. This is what you have. Okay. So you can have your ABC, A as MSP. So typically A is your LSB and C is your MSP. And based on that, we are trying to design. And now when I get all this expression and I have told there are three flip-flop that is required, A, B and C, this is what I am having. Corresponding JMK, JBKB, JCKC. And you can see that clock is common to all, same clock. All the flip-flops are triggered simultaneously. And we had seen just now, JA and K are 1-1. It is nothing but what provide VCC, 1 or VCC. JC, you can see that it is QA, QB or AB. Output of B, output of A, connected and given. That means output of QA and output QB, that is common, similar to this. Okay, this is your logic diagram. This is the logic diagram you have. These are the KMAPs that you have. Okay. And this is what we started with, the mod 6 synchronous subcounter using JK flip-flop. This was the sequence. And what all is required? We wanted excitation table. And then we are from the excitation table, from the present state, knowing the present state and the next state, we can construct what is J flip-flop inputs with respect to the transition table. And once we get this, then you have to get the expression for J and K of all the flip-flop, all three flip-flop. And that is what we have done here. And this is what the final logic design. So finally, whenever you are trying to design a synchronous counter, make sure you know which flip-flop you want to use, come up with the transition table corresponding to the excitation table, and then finally get the expression using KMAPs. And how many variable KMAP, that depends upon the present state plus the additional inputs. If you don't have additional inputs, it is the present state. Once you get the expression, get the logic diagram as shown. In the next session, we'll take up some more examples.